In this video, I'm going to show you guys how you can take an old iMac like this and hook it up to a laptop to use it as an external display. You can go your own way. Go your own way. Well, hey guys, Juan here. Thanks for stopping by my channel and checking out this video. So I'm going to show you guys how you guys can take an old iMac and use it as a second screen, a second monitor. But first, I want to tell you which ones you're able to do this with, because not every old iMac can be used as an external display or a target display, is how Apple would call it. But these are the, I'm going to throw them up here on the screen. These are the particular models that you're able to do this with. All right, so if you're using a 27-inch iMac, you can use a late 2009 all the way through a mid 2010. Those are the 27-inch iMacs that you're able to use. If you're using a 21.5-inch iMac, then you'll need a mid 2011 through mid 2014. Those are the models that you're able to use as far as an old iMac goes to achieve the second display. All right, so now I'm gonna give you guys the instructions on how to do this and what cables that you'll need in order to take your iMac and use it as an external display. I made a video about this a while back, so I'm gonna use some of that footage that talks about it in great detail. So let's go ahead and roll the footage. So if you're watching this, you're probably wanting to figure out how you can use an iMac to pair up with a MacBook Pro as an external monitor, and it's really easy to do. Now you may be wondering, why would I want to use an iMac as a monitor? Well, sometimes these ultra-wide monitors, or you know, bigger monitors, 27 inches or whatever you're looking to get, they can be a bit expensive. Maybe you have an iMac, an older iMac that you can possibly salvage and use as an external monitor, or maybe you can find an iMac on Facebook Marketplace or Craigslist or wherever you buy some of your used computer equipment, and you can get it at a lower cost. So this is a way that you can do that and get a bigger screen real estate than what you can on, say, like a Mac or a MacBook. So right here, I'm using a 13-inch newer MacBook Pro. It's one of the, I think it's 2017 is what this one is. But they make these now with just the USB-C port. So you gotta live that dongle life. Apple's made it a little bit more difficult now that they only have the USB-C inputs and they don't have those old HDMI imports like they used to on their older MacBook Pros. So in order to do this, you need an adapter. So what you'll need is an adapter that looks just like this. This is a Thunderbolt 3 to Thunderbolt 2 adapter. And I'll have a description or a link in the description down below of where you can get this. So on one end, it's a USB-C. On the other end, it's that DisplayPort Thunderbolt. Also, you'll need a Thunderbolt cable like this. So I went with a 0.5 meter cable. So it's kind of a short one just because I don't like a lot of wires being shown on my desk setup. So I went with the shortest one that they offer. So those are the two components that you'll need in order to do this. All right, so the first step is you'll need to have both of your devices turned on and logged on. So I've got my MacBook Pro here on and I've got my iMac ready to go. Next up, you'll need to connect your cables. So I'm going to take my Thunderbolt cable here and I'm going to connect it to the adapter, and I'm going to plug in the USB-C on one end of my MacBook Pro and take this other end here and plug it into my iMac. Let's do that now.
A few moments later.
Okay, so now that the cables are connected, you can see that I'm running Mojave here on my laptop, and here on the iMac I'm running an older operating system, but we're going to take a mirror this to this and make the MacBook Pro the main machine that's running. All you have to do now is hit Command F2. Okay, and now you can see both devices are connected together. This one's being used as an external monitor or an additional display to the MacBook Pro, and the MacBook Pro is the main machine running to both of these. So I hope this helped you out. Maybe it was a good solution for you. If you like this video, make sure you hit thumbs up and make sure you subscribe. I do tech videos and tech reviews all the time. Thanks a lot for watching this, guys. Until next time, be creative.